Let me quickly get your reaction to this very dramatic testimony that we're about to hear from Dr. Fiona Hill, the former top Russia advisor on the National Security Council. Among other things, she blasts those who believe it was Ukraine, not Russia, that interfered in the 2016 election. I know you've spent a lot of time investigating this yourself.
She is being a truth teller here, and she is going to be a no-nonsense witness with a lot of expertise. Someone who is right there in the White House advising the president, advising his team. And of course it's true. Christopher Wray, the FBI director, has said it. Dan Coats, the former director of national intelligence. All of the top intelligence people for the Trump administration, following what the Obama administration also had said, which is there is unbelievably strong proof here that Russia invaded our election. Of course, they did it with social media propaganda, and then they attempted to hack into the election equipment of all 50 states. And it wasn't just meddling. That's what I do when I call my daughter on a Saturday night and ask her what she's doing. No, this was an invasion. And they didn't use tanks, and they didn't use planes, but what they did use is a cyber attack. And for the president to act like he thought maybe it was Ukraine, when Ukraine actually has been a victim, just like the United States, of cyber attacks by Russia, that makes no sense at all.
You know, and it's interesting, the U.S. intelligence community has concluded during the Obama administration and during the Trump administration that the Russian goal was to sow political dissent here in the United States. And she writes this in her opening statement, Dr. Fiona Hill: the impact of the successful 2016 Russian campaign remains evident today. Our nation is being torn apart. Truth is questioned. Our highly professional expert career foreign service is being undermined. You agree with that assessment that from the Russian perspective, mission accomplished. There's a lot of political dissent as a result of all of this.
Yes. I think you also could hear the words of Marie Yovanovitch, that a career public servant who's given her life for diplomacy for our nation, when she said that basically the State Department has been hollowed out. Some of that is because of Donald Trump's constant foreign affairs dictates and the things that he's done and the things that he said that people disagree with. But a lot of this has to do with this divide all the time that we've seen all over the world. And a lot of this has been furthered. This is exactly what Russia wants. They want people to not like our government internationally. They want people to not like our government and our institutions domestically. They would literally play on both sides of the issue on social media, on energy, on guns. There's ample proof that they were literally putting up Facebook postings, some of them bought in rubles, on both sides of issues, getting me to my Honest Ads Act, which if we don't pass that, I don't know how we're ever going to be able to have fair elections. Because right now, anyone can buy ads on social media. A few of them are voluntarily posting them, but you literally can post what you want and you don't have to say who paid for it, like you do on CNN or on any other TV or radio.
Senator Bernie Sanders says that Democrats can't afford to be consumed by President Trump and this impeachment inquiry. How do you do that when you, for example, you would be acting, you're a United States senator, potentially as a juror in a Senate trial?
Well, I will have my constitutional duty. This comes first. This is a really important moment for our country as we look at a president that has put his private interests in front of our country's interests. And in real time right now, the American people are seeing it. But it does meld into this presidential campaign. I'm not going to think about it as a scheduling issue. I'm thinking about it as part of a bigger theme. I think you do have to talk about President Trump, because as you look at this election, you've got our fired up Democratic base, but you also have independents and moderate Republicans that see this as a patriotism check, a values check. As I said last night in the debate in Atlanta, a decency check. And they, yes, they don't like what's happening economically with pharmaceutical prices, health care, but a lot of them voted in Kentucky and Virginia and in other places. They voted Democratic because they just can't stand what this guy is doing to our country. If we don't understand that, we're going to screw up this election. And I'm the candidate that can bring these people in, along with our fired Democratic base, so we can win. So at the core of the impeachment proceeding, it is a legal proceeding. That is true. There's going to be tons of witnesses. But for the heart of America right now, This is a decency check on this guy. And whatever happens with his impeachment proceeding, they still don't want him in the White House. And if we lose those people because we put someone on the top of the ticket that is trying to throw them off their current insurance in 4 years or make everything free, we're not going to win big that we need to do to get things done like climate change, immigration reform, gun safety. That's the case I'll be making.
Before I let you go, Senator, very quickly, I want you to elaborate, if you can, a political question about your comments when you were asked at the debate last night about Mayor Pete Buttigieg and his qualifications to be president. Give us your sense.
I made very clear over the last few weeks that I think the mayor is qualified. And as I said last night, I'm honored to stand with him on the stage. But my bigger point was this. There is a higher standard for women in politics. All you have to do is look at our 45 past presidents and play the game, name your favorite woman president. There hasn't been one. There hasn't been a woman vice president. We must be held to some kind of higher standard. And I really wanted to make the voters think about it, not because I'm making the case, hey, elect me because I'm a woman. I've never made that case in any of my elections for DA or for senator. But I made the case because I want them to think differently. It doesn't have to be the tallest person in the room or the skinniest person in the room or the loudest person in the room. What should matter is this someone who can get things done and be competent and tell the truth and have the back of the American people. That's me. I passed over 100 bills across the aisle as the senator, as the lead Democrat. You want to win big? Look at what I've done, winning suburban districts, red rural districts, bright blue districts over and over again, bringing people with me, Republicans, independents, Democrats, leading a ticket. I don't see this as a personal victory. I see it as a national victory. So that was a point I really made in Atlanta. And I do value Mayor Pete's experience. I just think I'm more qualified. I've had that local experience, but I've also had 14 years in the private sector and 12 years in the U.S. Senate working to get things done for America. I think that should matter.